Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Sierra Nevada University 2021 Commencement Ceremony. At this time, let's clap for that. That's what you did. At this time, if all guests would like to please take their seats, we are going to begin the procession here in just a few minutes. Thank you.
I'm starry-eyed and wish everyone here enthusiastic welcome. In particular, I want to welcome the class of 2020 and the class of 2021. Soar Eagles! I want to thank Professor Dudley for escorting the graduates up to stage, the esteemed graduates. And please join me in thanking Donna Axton, our professor of music and psychology and the chair of the music department. Donna? The sun has come out. This is exciting. If you could please rise and join the graduates in the national anthem, being performed by Maddie Bowman, Sky Graves, Sixteen Picard, and Christina Viola. To have this campus. It's unfortunate we only do this once a year. We should be here all year on enjoying this campus. And I want to point somebody out today because this campus would not have been possible without her vision in making it a reality. Today we're visited by Dr. Nancy Stevens-Benz. Nancy, thank you, thank you, thank you for making this campus possible. Solomon as well. I don't know if he's here today, Nancy, but...
He was my partner in crime.
Thank you again. It's so special to have you here. Welcome to this special and long-awaited occasion. We are finally together to celebrate the 51st commencement of Sierra Nevada University. And what a year it's been. Quite a year. It continues to be. But today is a very, very special day. There's a spirit in the air that engenders positivity and genuine optimism. At SNU, our quest has been for students to get a genuine sense of belonging and self-confidence. As this is my first graduation address as a university president, this commencement will always mean something special to me. As your new president, my family and I would like to thank you for welcoming us here. And most importantly, we have a fervent belief that this is our tribe. And I hope you too, as graduates, have found your tribe here at Sierra Nevada University. We congratulate each graduate for their individual efforts and their accomplishments. Yet we also recognize and thank all those who have helped along the road, especially this year. How about a round of applause for your families? Your classmates. Your friends. And our professor, thank you, thank you. All graduates, as you are honored today with your family and friends, please accept our admiration for what you have achieved and what you have experienced, which has hopefully made you stronger, wiser, and more capable to take on the challenges of the future. This is the day when the years of hard work and the sacrifices you and others have made on your behalf are rewarded. We're tremendously proud of you. Sierra Nevada University is governed by an autonomous board of trustees. The trustees are private citizens who serve without remuneration and who set policy direction for the university. SNU is very grateful to these men and women for their unselfish contribution to our university. So I wanted to thank the board there. And now it is with great pleasure, I want to introduce members of the platform party. So in the back we have Sherry Lee O'Connor, Chair of the Department of Fine Arts, Justin Spees, Chair of the Department of Business, Dr. Suzanne Goldie, Chair of the Department of Science and Technology, Professor Dudley, Faculty Council Chair, thank you for all you do, Professor. June Saraceno, Chair of the Department of Humanities and Social Sciences, Dr. Chris Salute, Dean of Graduate Studies. Our Vice Chair, Janet Lowe. And our commencement speaker, author and expedition traveler, Richard Bangs. Thank you. The next group deserves recognition as our faculty. It is in their intellect, curiosity, creativity, and passion for teaching that gives us purpose here. Therefore, I ask the faculty to stand and for all of us to applaud them. Thank you, faculty. We have a special recognition that is bestowed at commencement each year, known as Perspective on Design. This honor recognizes an extraordinary graduating artist of Sierra Nevada University. Funded by anonymous donors, it is intended to reward an exceptional emerging artist by creating incentives to continue their work after graduation, while affirming their contributions to a vibrant regional and national artistic community. This year, it is my sincere pleasure to bestow this award on Hannah Friedholm. Hannah, please come forward to recognize this achievement. Come on up, we got something for you. We had our award ceremony yesterday, and Hannah was bestowed with a number of awards, but we want to make known her graduation. It is with great pleasure that I introduce our 2021 valedictorian. Kayla Heidenreich has been an outstanding student at Sierra Nevada University and graduates today with distinction as magna cum laude. She has earned her Bachelor's of Arts degree in Interdisciplinary Studies with majors in Journalism and Outdoor Adventure Leadership. That sounds simple, but that's quite a bit to take on. I had lunch with Kayla 3 or 4 weeks ago, and I found her life journey fascinating. I was genuinely impressed by her. And last night, I had the privilege of hosting with my wife, Veronica, the commencement speaker, Richard, and Kayla's family. And just to see the love and support and the communication between her family and Kayla was just an exceptional experience for both Veronica and I. So we thank the family for coming up, or down, I guess, all the way from Washington. Thank you very much. Kayla and I met, and she told me about her interest in outdoor leadership. She takes this training to heart, enthusiastically engaging in climbing and backpacking expeditions, leading student groups through their own training, generously sharing her experience and expertise. A highlight of her time here at SNU has been participation in Professor Lagasse's Arctic Refuge course, the trip of a lifetime to the Arctic to study sustainability. Through all her activities, she has been actively engaged in her pursuit of her second major, journalism, connecting it with her love for the outdoors and aiming her camera, recording her experiences to share with others. Her focus on journalism led her to her work on projects centered on indigenous tribes. We are enormously proud of Kayla and how she has made full use of her time here at SMU. In fact, Kayla will be putting her SMU learning to use immediately. Kayla is hoping to catapult the SMU service program and project into a position at the Alaska Wilderness Group. Proof in the power of SMU's penchants for applied learning, taking what the analysis and concepts from the classroom and applying them to the real world in a meaningful way. We look forward to hearing more from her in the months and years to come. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Kayla Heidenreich, scholar, journalist, leader, and the class of 2021 valedictorian.
This microphone makes me really nervous. I also took off my shoes because it made me feel better. I first would like to acknowledge the land we are all on. Today we are graduating on the traditional lands and territories of the indigenous Washoe tribe. It is important to recognize these people as they still exist and practice their culture. As we celebrate our accomplishments, let us celebrate the first people of this land that has been Washoe land since time immemorial. That is also so special to many of us. One night, 3.5 years ago, I woke up with my head pressed up against my steering wheel, with red and blue lights pulsating around me. I had no idea where I was or what had happened. Waking up the next morning in a jail cell, I learned that I had totaled my car driving on the wrong side of the freeway. I was drunk. I had gotten involved in the wrong crowd. I was directionless in life. I hated myself. I wished I had died that night. I was fortunate I had the guidance and unconditional support of my parents and loved ones. This was also when I was introduced to Sierra Nevada University, although at the time it felt almost accidental. I was a wide-eyed 19-year-old who came here to play on the soccer team and learn about how to run around the mountains. I felt as if it was a shot in the dark coming here. I suddenly was surrounded with beautiful people who taught me what healthy friendships can mean. I had small classes with teachers like Brennan Legacy and Jim Scripps who inspired me and truly lit passion within me. I was given knowledge on how to properly recreate within the uniquely gorgeous Sierras from experts like Daryl Tayton and Rosie Hackett. I had all of you who pushed me to be better. Field courses where I was almost encouraged to make mistakes in order to learn. I learned how to use my voice to make a difference in my community and even across the nation. People believed in me and taught me to believe in myself. I love the word intent. I have started waking up in the morning and writing my intentions down for the day. I intentionally compliment strangers. I tell myself I love myself with intent. I intentionally work on dissolving my ego, and I intentionally tell people that I love them. When I first came to the school, I did not live my life with intention. I did not even know what this word meant or the power behind it. This school gave me that intention. This past year has been difficult for most of us. On top of a global pandemic, the acrimonious political climate in the country, and the repercussions of a worldwide climate crisis, life looks pretty scary. This year, I found myself struggling to keep my hope. I was scared of the state of the world, and I felt a dark cloud looming over me. What was I going to do that would make a difference in the world? Was I fighting a battle I had no chance of winning? Were my good intentions enough? I then would go to class and see that Kara is changing the policies for how we take care of our rivers. I see that Megan is going to spend the rest of her life protecting the planet's birds. Clayton is inspiring people to take a chance and live a life full of adventure. I see Cam creating sustainable furniture, Michelle finding ways to reconnect people with the earth, Emily giving those voices who have been oppressed a platform, Matt devoting his time to wilderness therapy, and Jose finding ways to fight wildfires. Looking out into this crowd of college graduates today makes the world less scary. Watching you all change pieces of the world around me is the only reason why I am standing up here today. I'm inspired every day to do my part in changing the world because you've all invited me to walk with you as you do your parts. I know I can count on every single one of you, and I promise you can count on me. I just got back from my last class here at SNU. Along with 20 of my classmates, I paddled for 9 days down the Rogue River, traditional lands and territories of the Tututni and Tacoma tribes. We camped along the riverside, ate homemade pad thai, looked at bugs in the water with Andy, and floated down the most beautiful canyon I've ever seen, all while somehow getting college credit. One night, as we laughed around the campfire, one of our middle-aged professional rafting guides looked at me with tears in his eyes. He nudged me and with a soft smile said, "I never felt so assured that our future was going to be okay until now." The knowledge and inclusiveness of this group is truly beautiful. He described Daryl and Andy, our SNU teachers, as two of the best leaders he has ever seen. This trip acts as a small-scale example of our school as a whole. It created the space for experiences to develop, allowing for personal connections that go deeper than words in a lecture hall. We all have a role to play. Starting almost as a whim, Sierra Nevada University became a life-altering experience. Teachers like Brennan became mentors and pushed me to discover my truest passions in life. I never thought I would be sad to graduate college, but here we are. I'm sad to leave this place which fueled so much of my growth. I'm sad to leave the people who push me to never just accept things for the way they are. I'm sad to leave the teachers who call me when I don't show up to class. I'm scared to stop learning. But thankfully, this school has taught me that with an open mind, I will never stop learning. With the help of the interdisciplinary program, I now have a better understanding of how interconnected the world is and the importance of each of us in it. I'm glad I didn't die on the side of that freeway 3.5 years ago. I understand that I have a purpose to stand up for people on the planet, and I have this school and everyone sitting here today to thank for that. Thank you.
Thank you, Kayla. She said she was very, very nervous. And can I go down now? I just want to thank her. She just did a wonderful job of giving a speech from the heart. Our students rock here. They really, really did. They really, really did. Thank you, guys. It's a nice segue. It is my honor to introduce Ronan Hill, president of the Student Government Association. Ronan!
First objective of the day was to not fall off the ramp, so I feel good today. As I said, my name is Ronan Hill. Please do not rush the stage all at once. I'd like to give another congratulations to the graduating class of 2021. Let's hear it for you guys. And while I don't have the answer to a lot of life's big questions, or any of life's big questions, I would like to share that maybe something the people on my right haven't shared with you or back in the back. If you're a little nervous about what happens here after today, you don't know what you're gonna do, I'll share with you that no one has any idea what they're doing, and we're all just kind of guessing and putting it together. So don't feel nervous. I just keep showing up here and they keep electing me for positions that I really don't feel qualified for. So I'm telling you, if you just do things every day that challenge you, make you happy, you try to better yourself each and every day, you'll find yourself closer to mastery than you could have ever imagined. But the reason I'm up here today is to give the senior gift for 2021, and I don't think any of you really know what it is. So, it comes from the SGA fund, so now that I have all of your money, I spent it on whatever I want. Your senior gift will be spent on a total revamping of the on-campus activities department. It will be used for both SGA and student affairs life, and it will be used for on-campus and off-campus students to come and enjoy and have a good time and enjoy each other's company. And that's all I have for you today. Thank you for having me, all of you.
The SGA has been instrumental this year. What he did not mention was when we were up against the big force of COVID, the SGA contributed and shared in the cost of the vaccinations and the like. So thank you, the SGA, and thank you, Ronan, for making that possible. Also, I thought it was a really good spring formal. So for those that were there, thank you for the opportunity of attending. It was heartwarming for my wife and I to be there to see the students interacting. And for those that might be there next year, definitely attend. So moving on, I've asked Lauren Rose, Vice President of the SGA, to introduce this year's commencement speaker, Richard Bain. Rich? Lauren? Where are you? There she is. Come on up, Lauren. That was supposed to be done by Ronan. It's okay.
Has challenged us in ways that generations of students before us couldn't have imagined. But despite the hurdle of navigating a pandemic while earning our degrees, we persevered. In the face of a horrific global crisis, we chose empathy. We chose education. We chose to stand apart, but together. We now have a magnitude of grit and hardiness that those generations of students before us also couldn't have imagined. We have been strengthened by the struggle and forged a path of tenacity and leadership that will be trod upon by years of students to come. Richard Bangs has been forging paths for 30 years. Known as the father of modern adventure travel, he has led the first descents of 35 rivers around the globe, including the Yangtze in China and the Zambezi in southern Africa. Richard has served as the president of Outward Bound, an organization that nurtures skill building and personal growth through the challenge of outdoor expeditions. In 2007, he won the Marc Dubois Lifetime Achievement Conservation Award. Richard Bangs is also a digital pioneer, founding and producing multiple websites like TerraQuest, Expedia.com, and Great Escapes, a Microsoft travel initiative. Richard has published 19 books and over 1,000 magazine articles. His most recent novel, The Lost River, a memoir of life, death, and the transformation of wild water, won the National Outdoor Book Award and the Lowell Thomas Award. An artist in many mediums, Richard executive produced the Emmy-winning PBS series, Richard Bangs Adventures with Purpose, and his special, Quest on the Kadiakatonga, won the CINE Golden Eagle Award in 2008. Richard's film, Quest for the Viking Spirit, won the 2009 Gold Lowell Thomas Award for Best Documentary, and Hong Kong, Quest for the Dragon, was awarded the Lowell Thomas Travel Journalism Gold Award in 2011. Richard Bangs received 2 Emmys in 2010. Graduates and guests, it's my great honor to invite to the podium digital creator, explorer, writer, and filmmaker, Richard Bangs.
Okay.
Well, first of all, I want to thank the Academy and all the other talented nominees. That's a wrong speech. I want to thank Kayla. What an amazing speech. You are a hard act to follow. And I want to thank Greg Wagner, who sought me out and invited me to this occasion. And of course, Deans Rosie Hackett and Andy Roast. And then President Rob Valley, and the pizza, the delicious pizza and chips we had last night at this house. And then, of course, the class of 2021. And this hat. So, there are 30,000 days in your life. When I was 24, I realized I was almost 9,000 days down. There are no warm-ups, no practice rounds, no reset buttons. Your biggest risk isn't failing, it's getting too comfortable. Every day we're writing a few more words of a story. I wanted my story to be an adventure, and that has made all the difference. I only have 4 pieces of wisdom to impart at this point. Adventure matters, embrace failure, pursue your passion, and follow the stones. The first comes from watching so many of my own fellow grads set out on a path of adventure, but then who settled for safety and comfort over risk, from witnessing once courageous friends who chose the feather bed of civilization over the rough unknown. It seems to be a natural arc of life for many, experimentation when young, then surrendering to a groove as quickly as possible. The problem with this course is that it does not allow evolution of thought or being. Only through being bold are new frontiers forged, innovations made, and advancements achieved. Adventure matters because it allows discovery of the self, of those encountered, of the world. If the sole goal of a ship is to stay safe, it would never leave port. Embracing failure, the second pillar, means accepting that when you stick your neck out, things sometimes go wrong, but that great unexpected things can come from these accidents. The company I founded, Sobek Expeditions, came about through personal failure. I became a professional river guide on the Colorado River to the Grand Canyon when I was 19. When I heard National Geographic was organizing a first descent down the Omo River to the Grand Canyon of Africa, I wanted to join and figured I was eminently qualified. I went to visit the man in charge and told him I wanted to be part of the team. He said I was too scrawny and to buff up and come back in a few months. And then he would hire me on. So I did. I worked out every day for 6 months, drank to excess terribly tasting nutrient shakes, and took on a pre-steroid Sylvester Stallone look. But when I returned to show off my new super-toned self, the man said there was no room for me. He hired his brother in my stead. I had failed. But that catapulted me in a different direction. I felt, what the hell, I could organize my own expedition, and I did, recruiting several guide friends, finding sponsors, and heading over to Africa months before National Geographic. Needless to say, Geographic was pissed. Especially when I returned and showed them our photographs of our first descent under the banner of what we named Sobek Expeditions. Sobek has since transported and transformed thousands of folks from all over the world. And by sharing the magic of wild places and integrous cultures, Sobek has helped preserve thousands of acres of threatened lands, wildlife, and peoples. As for National Geographic, time buried the resentment, and for the last 10 years, Sobek has run all the National Geographic adventures. Years later, I engineered another big flop. I was hired by Microsoft to create an online travel product, and I put all my resources into an online magazine called Mungo Park, named after the Scottish explorer who discovered the Niger River. I had gobs of money to spend. Microsoft was the god of tech profits back then, and I dispatched famous people all over the world, Tom Clancy to cover a space shuttle, Martha Stewart to kayak Newfoundland, Lyle Levitt to motorcycle the length of Chile. But after 2 years, the product had made no money, and Bill Gates shut me down. I had failed. But someone noticed that a little application we had built to allow our audience to book trips and follow the celebrity footsteps had some traction. And so as Mungo Park was shuttered, the travel app Expedia was spun out, and it became the multi-billion dollar business it is today. Now, without risk, there can be no reward. And you are so fortunate to be graduating from this magic casket of promises, this mountain of blazing poetry, this lake that embraces the ethos of risk. Sustainability and environmental education teach the soft skills the world wants and needs. Respect for the environment, empathy, resilience, risk management, tolerance for adversity, self-awareness, leadership, group dynamics, all these are learned through doing. But risk with calculation and caution is the key. Sobek Expeditions was premised on river exploration, which by its very nature is an enterprise with a high degree of risk. But by the time we set out to make the first descent of the Zambezi River in southern Africa, the media had caught on to us. Everyone from ABC to BBC to National Geographic came to cover us, and there were helicopters and cameras everywhere. About a week down the river, we came to a huge rapid just as twilight was settling in. The first raft threw capsized, and the guide took a nasty swim. The second boat did the same, with the guide swept around the corner downstream. Now it was my turn, and the media, smelling blood, were ready to pounce. But I didn't want to take the chance of swimming a big, dangerous rapid in a river with crocodiles at near dusk. So I tied everything down as tightly as possible and kicked the boat out into the current with no guide or passengers, a ghost boat, and it made a perfect run. The point being, in the calculus of risk, there is no shame in survival. There is nothing wrong with the creative solution over the hero run, because ultimately it's those who come back who move the pieces forward that help better understand and improve our world. Now, with all the adventures that life presents, pursue the ones that fire your passions. One of my heroes is Richard Burton, a 19th century explorer who was the first European to penetrate large parts of Africa. Though commissioned by the Royal Geographical Society, Burton really set out to satisfy his own insatiable curiosity about foreign life, languages, and exotic sex. He was an adventurer who sought out perfectly unnecessary hazards in the name of inquisitiveness and pursued the unknown not for empire or some larger good, but for his own love of discovery. He pursued his passion. Ernest Shackleton was another passion pursuer. For his ill-conceived plan to cross Antarctica, he had major sponsors and promoted his imperial expedition as scientific, though he had no interest in science and he even scorned it. The real reasons for the extreme endeavor were personal. He loved a good adventure. He loved the romantic notion of searching for fortune, and he loved to sing, jig, and joke with his mates in the field. Everything else was an excuse. Others came to personify this type of passion and adventure in a more direct way, such as Wilfred Thesiger, who loved the desert and spent 40 years exploring its inner reaches, including the crossing of Arabia's empty quarter. When Teddy Roosevelt decided to explore the River of Doubt in Brazil, he said, "I had to go. It was my last chance to be a boy." Richard Branson did that, setting records for the first hot air balloon to cross the Atlantic and the oldest person to cross the English Channel by kiteboard. Robin Davidson became the first woman to cross the Australian desert by camel. Yvonne Chouinard, Jimmy Chin, Hadley Hammer, Lindsay Dyer, Bill Briggs, they all personify this indomitable spirit of exploration, following some irresistible inner call to shred the limits, find terra incognita, and prove their passions. They have dogged their dreams, made a good living, and generated awareness and support for their interests and causes. This, then, is the good truth, that it is better to go forward and be in the ring and perhaps suffer the consequences than to never step at all and wither on the inside. If you can resist the temptation to stay in the safe harbor, if you can take the terror of the open seas or steep slopes, you can make a difference for yourself, and for those with whom you come in contact. And this is not just physical fear. It can be the fear of not meeting parents' expectations or embarking on a path that might not be met with approval or running out of money. But when you confront fear, that is when you are most alive. That is when the envelopes are ripped and the breakthroughs are made. I believe that pursuing your passion, tracking that adventure, allows a lifetime deep and rich and connected, and that it is better than the shelter and security of a dull but safe existence. As for the Stones, Mick Jagger and Keith Richards are both 77 years old, and they are still touring. We should all be performing concerts of our passions when we are in our 70s. They found something they loved at an early age, and they never looked back. Even if we don't make it, we should shoot for the long term. The Stones probably have the best commencement advice of all time. You can't always get what you want, but if you try some time, you just might find you get what you need. So may your water and slopes be white, and here's to adventures yet to dare, epic stories yet to share, and cool gear yet to wear. Don't just learn it, live it. Thank you.
Follow your passions and good things happen. I now have the special honor of introducing Janet Lowe, Vice Chair of the SNU Board of Trustees. Janet holds a Bachelor's of Science in Chemical Engineering from the University of Texas and an MBA from Rice University. She began her career with Shell Oil and was promoted to become one of the youngest engineers in management. In 1989, Janet co-founded CPLEX, a software company that she helped operate for 10 years before selling to iLog, a publicly traded French company. Janet remained there as an executive over 10 years until it was sold to IBM in 2008. Janet and her husband Todd have lived in Incline Village since 1991 and have raised twin daughters who are now professionals. Janet, please join us here.
The most joyous vote we take as trustees of this university is the conferring of degrees. And every year I remind myself this grounds us in why we do what we do, and this is it. And my greatest privilege as a member of the Board of Trustees is to be able to speak on behalf of them and congratulate the class of 2021, the parents and the family that make this happen, and also the friends, and last but definitely not least, the faculty who are what make this possible and guide these students every day through this journey, and we value what we do. The only thing standing between you and your diplomas is the reading of the mandamus, and it is blessedly short, and more importantly, it's even shorter than it looks because Christine printed this out in super big print for me so I wouldn't have to use reading glasses. So, here goes. The Board of Trustees, in accordance with the Charter of Sierra Nevada University, reserves the authority to approve the granting of academic degrees. With the unanimous approval of the Board of Trustees, I hereby delegate to the President the authority to confer these degrees. Mr. President, please proceed.
Thank you, Janet. I would like to introduce Professor Russell Dudley. Russell, thank you for all you do.
Hello, mine is also mercifully short. Mr. President, I present to you the candidates, all of whom have met the requirements of their degree as prescribed by the faculty of the university. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Russell. Would the candidates please rise? Upon the recommendation of the faculty of Sierra Nevada University and the authority vested in me from the Board of Trustees as President of Sierra Nevada University, I confer upon each of you the degrees you have earned as printed in the official program for the 51st commencement ceremony of Sierra Nevada University, with all the rights, privileges, prerogatives pertaining to thereto. So let's celebrate. Will the candidates for Masters of Education and Masters of Arts and Teaching please come forward? Dr. Christopher Salute, Dean of Graduate Studies, will introduce the candidates and we'll hand the diplomas off. Thank you.
While our candidates line up, I just want to thank Dr. Winship-Garner for letting me announce our candidates and letting me take my mask off for the next 10 minutes. I also want to note, while every single person and every single student has had their own challenge this 18 months during COVID, our teacher education department was on the front line educating other students and dealing with their unique situations and challenges. So we just want to give them a big round of applause. And you may take your mask off when you're getting your diploma. Come on up. Zuri Merchant Diabra, Master of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education. Lauren Bloom, Master of Arts in Teaching and Special Education. Emlyn Mikhail Caiwano, Master of Arts in Teaching and Special Education. Shannon Marie Johnson, Master of Arts in Teaching and Special Education. Brenda Ramirez, Master of Arts in Teaching and Special Education. Ashley Lisa Butera, Master of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education. Tori Maria Wilson, Master of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education. Robert Andrew Ingalls, Master of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education. Amber Elizabeth Dirk, Master of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education. Alma Zulema Medina, Master of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education. Claire Aline Riordan, Master of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education. Corey Donahue, Master of Arts in Teaching and Elementary Education. Christopher W. Robbins, Master of Arts in Teaching and Secondary Education. Benjamin I. Gray, Master of Arts in Teaching and Secondary Education. Ruth Ann Singson Gilstrap, Master of Education in English Language Acquisition and Development. Barbara Jean Keith, Master of Education and Administration. Lauren Harney Stevenson, Master of Education and Administration. Josie C. Cruz, Master of Education in Administration. Victoria Lynn Ponessa, Master of Education in Administration. And Jacqueline Raker, Master of Education in Administration. Thank you to all of our graduates.
inductive salute. Congratulations to the graduates. Will the candidates for Masters of Fine Arts and Interdisciplinary Arts please rise and come forward? Professor Russell Dudley will introduce the candidates. Russell?
Hello again, folks. The Master of Fine Arts in Interdisciplinary Arts program is a summer program. Most of our students and faculty come from all over the country and is a significant part of the vitality of our sort of summertime. Christina has made the trip out from Colorado to be with us today, so I welcome Christina Bell.
Candidates for Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, please rise and come forward. Justin Spies, Chair of the Department of Business, will introduce the candidates. Justin?
We are so proud of all of our business students. Thank you to all the families, to the faculty members, to the staff, to the administration on this momentous occasion. Madeline Corrine Johnson, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Global Business, Management and Ski Business Resort Management, with a minor in Marketing, graduating magna cum laude at valedictorian candidate. Adrian Bertram Romberg, Bachelor in Science in Business Administration and Global Business Management and Finance and Economics, graduating magna cum laude valedictorian candidate. V.R. Beating, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Global Business Management and Finance and Economics, graduating cum laude. Amy Christine Artis, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Marketing, graduating cum laude. Kevin Bishop, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Marketing. Keaton Kissack, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Marketing. Juan Carlos O'Neill, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Marketing. Kyle Anthony Mannix, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Entrepreneurship, graduating magna cum laude. Ashley Lynn Easley, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Marketing, graduating summa cum laude, valedictorian candidate. Victoria Haley Ratto, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Global Business Management. Jonas Patton, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Finance and Economics with a minor in English. Hunter Lamoureux, graduating in Global Business Management. Bachelor of Science in Global Business. Joseph Thompson, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Ski Business, Resort Management, and Finance and Economics. Devin Lucas, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Ski Business and Resort Management and Marketing. Zachary Compton, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Global Business Management, and Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Chandler C. Peck, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Global Business Management. Andrew Thomas Bragg, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Ski Business and Resort Management. Kyle M. Gomez Flowers, graduating in Global Business Management, Bachelor of Science. Clayton Bright Ritchie, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Ski Business and Resort Management. Theodore Hoffman, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Marketing. Breck Ann Breschlein, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Marketing. Benjamin Hojnowski, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and Marketing. Congratulations to all of our business students. Thank you all. Congratulations.
Thank you, Justin. Will the candidates for Bachelors of Arts in Art and Bachelor of Fine Arts in Art please rise and come forward? Sherry Lee O'Connor, Chair of the Department of Fine Arts, will introduce the candidates. Sherry?
Congratulations. I'm so excited for you today. I want to thank the Fine Arts faculty for doing everything possible to get these students to the place they are today walking across the stage. I appreciate your dedication and all that you've done for these students. Thank you. Dejanary, oh boy, Mestis. Bachelor of Fine Arts and Arts for the concentration in interdisciplinary practices, graduating cum laude. From 2020, Adrian Pinal. Bachelor of Fine Arts and Arts with a concentration in three-dimensional practices. Ryan Rady, Bachelor of Arts in Art. Sarah Mochel, Bachelor of Fine Arts and Arts with a concentration in digital arts and a minor in sustainability, graduating magna cum laude. Hannah Friedholm, Bachelor of Fine Arts and Arts with a concentration in three-dimensional practices, graduating summa cum laude, valedictorian candidate. And from 2020, Kirsten Vickery, Bachelor of Fine Arts and Arts with a concentration in three-dimensional practices. Congratulations.
Thank you, Sherry. Will the candidates for Bachelor of Arts in Humanities, English, Psychology, and Interdisciplinary Studies, and Bachelor of Fine Arts in Creative Writing please rise and come forward? Jane Saraceno, Chair of the Department of Humanities and Social Sciences, will introduce the candidates. June?
Thank you to all of the humanities faculty, including our interdisciplinary faculty as well.
Yeah, Tucker!
Ariana Naomi Gonzalez, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Juan P. Prieto, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Haley R. Wallstrom, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Creative Writing with a concentration in screenwriting, graduating cum laude. Catherine Ward, Bachelor of Arts in English, graduating cum laude. Jennifer Voorhees, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Creative Writing, graduating summa cum laude, valedictorian candidate. Miranda Jacobson, aka MJ, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Creative Writing with a minor in Journalism, graduating magna cum laude. Lauren Rose, Bachelor of Fine Arts in Creative Writing with a minor in Outdoor Adventure Leadership, graduating summa cum laude, valedictorian candidate. Nicholas Leon Friegel, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, graduating cum laude. Kevin M. Brun, Bachelor of Science in General Studies, graduating summa cum laude. Matthew W. Schultz, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology with a minor in Outdoor Adventure Leadership, graduating magna cum laude. Brittany Kirkland, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Blake Carla Voros, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Jamie Ann DeFrank, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology with a minor in Humanities, graduating cum laude. Brianna Dunsing, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Alma Patricia Ramirez Sanchez, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Tucker Abbott Brady, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Christy L. Kuhn, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology. Anna Wagda, Bachelor of Arts in Psychology, graduating magna cum laude. Michelle Williams, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with a discipline in Sustainability Studies, graduating magna cum laude. Emily Tesmier, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with disciplines in Journalism and Communication, graduating summa cum laude. Madison Schultz, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with disciplines in Journalism and Communication, graduating cum laude. Zoe Allison Tuttle, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with disciplines in Journalism and Communications. This one. Kayla Heidenreich, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with disciplines in Outdoor Adventure Leadership and Journalism. Adventure Leadership, graduating magna cum laude, valedictorian candidate. Kara Faye Campbell, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with disciplines in Outdoor Adventure Leadership and Environmental Science, graduating magna cum laude. Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with disciplines in Sustainability and Environmental Science. Cameron J. Brogue, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with a discipline in Sustainability Studies and a minor in Outdoor Adventure Leadership. Kyle Edward Hogan Barnes, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with disciplines in Digital Art and Marketing, graduating magna cum laude. Connor Messinger, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with disciplines in Digital Art and Marketing. Alexander J. Simpson, Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies with disciplines in Outdoor Adventure Leadership and Digital Art. Congratulations.
June. Will the candidates for Bachelor of Science please rise and come forward? Dr. Suzanne Gullery, Chair of the Department of Science and Technology, will introduce the candidates. Come on up.
As our candidates line up, I'd like to have the science faculty stand so we can acknowledge you. Our science faculty are the best, and I think the students will agree. They all have a great time and learned a ton. Victor Porras, Bachelor of Science in Biology, graduating magna cum laude, valedictorian candidate. Megan Dawn Gaston, Bachelor of Science in Biology with a minor in Management, graduating cum laude. Lauren Rose, Bachelor of Science in Biology, and you noticed also a Bachelor of Fine Arts in Creative Writing, graduating summa cum laude, valedictorian candidate, and a Department of Scholars. Madison Michelle Bowman, Bachelor of Science in Biology with a concentration in Sports Medicine, graduating summa cum laude, valedictorian candidate. Megan Rebecca Yount, Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science with a concentration in Ecology. Wyatt Justin Plumley, Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science with a concentration in Natural Resource Management. Yeah. Molly Ann Lee, Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science with a concentration in Natural Resource Management, graduating cum laude. Hunter Thomas Allen, Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science with a concentration in Earth Science, graduating summa cum laude, valedictorian candidate. Jose Antonio Speedy Ortiz, Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science with a concentration in Natural Resources Management. Jay Davis, Bachelor of Science in Biology.
Thank you, Suzanne. At this time, would all master's degree graduates please rise once again, the master's degree graduates. How about a round of applause? Master's degree graduates, would you confirm the degrees that you've earned? Please wear with pride your hoods, which are a symbol of your professional achievements and your dedication to your fields. Wear them with pride and recognition of your accomplishments. Please be seated. Thank you. At this time, would all bachelor degree graduates please rise once again? Bachelor's degree graduates, with the conferring of the degree you have earned, you may move the tassel on your caps from right to left. In recognition of your accomplishments and new academic status. Well done. Congratulations. You may be seated. Perfect timing. Listen, commencement is a time for famous quotes by notable contributors to business and culture. I would like to share a personal favorite from an author, educator, and businessman, Stephen Covey, most widely known for writing the book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. As a public speaker, he was known for many quotes, but few people are aware of the one that I give you now. Embossed inside almost all my suits is the following phrase. Live life in crescendo. Live life in crescendo, right on the tail end of Richard Banks' comments. Crescendo is the highest or loudest point in intensity. Covey would go on to say, living life in crescendo means that my most important work is always ahead of me, never behind me. Start living your life in crescendo. And remember, your most important work is ahead of you, not behind you. There's so much more to do, to learn, and to contribute. Graduates, you may think your work is done now. That is absolutely incorrect. The best, the most important, is yet to come. Sierra Nevada University is proud to have been a part of your beginning, and I hope you know we will continue to be here for you as you set out now on your most important work. Wherever and in whatever field that is, we can't wait to hear from you again, and we hope you check in with us often. Every day when I had the opportunity to drop my kids off, Xavier and Luke, to school, I asked them to repeat a phrase. And I think it sums up some of the values that I believe this institution's about. It's a simple phrase. Be engaged. Be curious. Be kind. And have fun. Congratulations to all graduates. Best wishes as you go forward from this commencement to begin your careers and life journey as graduates of Sierra Nevada Universities. You are SNU's greatest ambassadors. Live life in crescendo. Soar, Eagles. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you the graduating class of 2021 and the newest alumni of Sierra Nevada University. Let the recessional begin. Congratulations.